Balanced on a candle in front of a dimly lit light up mirror. I want it to be dark. Don't get mad at me for having it this dark. These lashes are super annoying, by the way. I also don't know if I like the way they look. I don't know. First, I'd like to say that I'm sorry that this is a update, like kind of like after update. I have like two videos to post, but we're gonna get onto that later in the video. We're just gonna get onto the updates because I already smoked two bowls, so I'm pretty fucking fried. Like, I mean, I guess I can hit the dip pen so I can prove to you that I'm fried, you know? Okay, first update is I finally got a new phone. My brother, he said he would put me on, his phone plan because my mother will not ever put a phone in her name. And I don't want a phone in her name anyway because she just takes it and searches it all the time. Even though, like, yeah, whatever. We're not gonna get into that. I literally have like PTSD from that. But I got this new phone and I ordered it off of the Sprint website, and I ordered an iPhone 8 Plus because it was zero today. I wanted an 11, but it was like $150 today, and my brother was like, I'm not letting you spend that on a phone. Like, you need to start making smart decisions, blah, blah, blah. And so the website, Sprint website, only had two options for colors. And it was light gray and space gray, like the dark gray. And so I chose space gray. And when the phone came, despite me clicking space gray on the website, it came rose gold. So I have a rose gold iPhone 8 Plus. Whatever goes the way Lilia wants it to go, right? Am I right? Like, nothing. But I will finally have better quality videos, even though it's still dark. When it's like bright, the quality will be better. I hope you can already tell the difference. One of the reasons I haven't been posting, my hair, like, literally has been coming out in clumps. Like, when I run my fingers through it in the shower, my hand is just covered in hair. It's like mostly stress about money and what the fuck I'm gonna do with my life. Everyone is so fucking lucky because everyone was given a better life. I was definitely given the shitty cards in life. Everyone, even like one of my daily struggles, I have to walk 30 minutes to work every day, stand on my feet every day, then walk 30 minutes home. And I know that doesn't seem like a lot, but I'm anemic, and like, I'm anemic as fuck. So when I even stand for an hour, let alone walk in the heat 30 minutes, like a mile walk, it is so fucking hard. And doing that every single day, 5 days straight, is so difficult. And everyone there, like, has a car. Like, my friends, like, were just given cars by their parents, or their boyfriends drive them places, like, to work every single day. And I'm just not fortunate enough to have that. And like, shit, I didn't even get two parents. Like, luck, people are so fucking lucky they get two parents, born into a rich family, get a car when they turn 16. Like, I don't even have a parent. Like, one parent is gone and the other one is mentally abusive as fuck and drunk as fuck every day and really fucking rude. We'll get into that later too. It is hard enough for me to go to work every day and I just keep blowing through my checks so fast. I have to get my license and start paying car insurance. I have to pay my phone bill, which is $60 a month, graduate, get an apartment, buy furniture for that apartment, literally all within a year, like under a year, and money is the only thing on my mind right now. I literally am starting to hate my job. After walking 30 minutes there every day, first of all, here's some little things that I hate about it. All of my other jobs let me wear leggings, and this job makes me wear jeans. And before I started working here, I had not put on a pair of jeans for 2 years, so I don't have jeans that fit me. Like, I literally have like two pairs of jeans that I can wear and they don't even fit. And this job, they have only given me one shirt and I have to wear that shirt every single day. Like, we can't wear anything else besides that shirt. And everyone else has multiple fucking shirts. And I only have one fucking shirt. Turd. No face or neck tattoos. But I can have, like, a whole arm sleeve. But, like, no visible face or neck tattoos. Like, I have to go out of my way to cover my face and neck tattoos. But I can have my whole arm and hand out. And it's, like, fine. And no piercings. But two on each ear. And a nostril, but I can have a nostril but not a septum. And they're really strict about the septum. Like, the area manager hates the fucking septum ring. If it's not coming out of my face and biting you, I don't see what the fuck your issue is. It is not your face. And it's not hurting you. If it's not hurting you, mind your own fucking business. It doesn't look unprofessional. Piercings aren't unprofessional. That's rude as fuck to say that. Like, any body, that's a body modification. What if I want to say your fucking big ass boob job looks unprofessional? Like, that's rude as fuck. You wouldn't say that to someone. Like, this is just like a little body modification that's not hurting anyone. Get your head out of your ass, you close-minded fuck. Triggered. And everyone there is just pissing me off. And they talk shit about each other behind their backs. And they say shit about me, like, when I first started working there. When the people said, I don't know about her because her tattoos. Like, I didn't know we were judging people based off tattoos. Like, okay. Like, I may look fucking intimidating. Like, I don't even look intimidating. Like, I have a resting bitch face and I have tattoos. But as soon as you approach me, like, I light up. Like, I love talking to people and I will be nice as fuck to you. Unless you give me a reason not to be, and then I will be the coldest bitch you will ever fucking meet, and I will make your life a living hell. But I don't do that shit where it's treat people the way you want to be treated. I treat you the way you treat me. Don't get that shit twisted. And that's how it's gonna be. Simple as that. And another thing, I'm struggling so hard to find motivations, and I really want to start posting like story times and different videos. And there's one about my experience with Molly that I want to fucking talk about, because I had two completely different experiences and I really want to share it, but I'm literally just struggling to find the motivation to get out of bed. So yeah, I need my Adderall refilled. I just want this channel to grow, and it's never gonna grow if we don't fucking post. There's two videos coming out with me, Katie, and then me, Katie, and Cheyenne. but I can't get the videos transferred from this old phone to my new phone because my parents have had the Wi-Fi off for the past 2 days. And if you know, before I just got this phone, I had two trap phones that had no service, so I was only dependent on Wi-Fi. I could not use the phones if I didn't have Wi-Fi. Now I don't have that problem. Fuck my parents. I don't need you holding this shit over my head anymore and making me scared as fuck every time I come home, wondering if I am coming home to my Wi-Fi turned off so I can't talk to my friends, watch YouTube, or do anything. So I'm just completely isolated again. That constant fear is no longer over my fucking head. They've just been pushing it.
And I'm about to snap.
Nothing is never good enough for them. Nothing I do is ever good enough for them. Even today, she told me when I walked in from my smoke break, she was like, I have a list of chores for you to do this weekend. And I said, why? And she said, because you haven't been doing the things that you're supposed to be doing. Even though I've been getting so much schoolwork and going done and going to work every day, despite the lack of motivation and stress. And I haven't been doing enough. Like, that's not enough. Okay. I want to make a whole video on her, but she just has my mind so fucking manipulated. I don't even know what she's doing. Like, I literally don't even know what she's doing to me anymore until Cheyenne is like, what the fuck? And gets mad as fuck. The other day, to my brother, because he bought me the car, she was like, I think it was a bad idea that you bought that car. And he was like, why? I did it for Lilia. Like, I'm doing it for her. And it's literally almost completely done now. And she was like, that makes it even worse. And he was like, how? And she was like, she didn't even earn it. Like, how did I not earn it? And my brother told me, he was like, I literally just wanted to do this for you because no one did it for me. And I know that I wanted someone to do it for me, so I wanted to do it for you. And that's why I'm helping you out with this phone, because I know how much of a crazy bitch she's being and blocking your Wi-Fi. And I know how bad that is for you and how much you're doing and how much you accomplished. Because I tell my brother about YouTube and tattooing. He bought me the fucking tattoo gun, like, to help me start. YouTube is, like, the only thing that is motivating me to keep going. Because, like, I really just want to keep getting videos out and getting our channel growing. So I can, like, meet more people like me. Like, I love when people reach out to me and fucking talk to me. But I just have no fucking motivation for YouTube. But it's, like, the only thing that motivates me to keep going. So I need to keep doing this fucking YouTube, but I don't have my Adderall prescription. I need that shit filled. It's getting filled down, so don't even worry about it. Don't worry. Okay. The last fucking thing of tea that I'm about to spill with you guys. Actually, let's hit the pen first, because this is a doozy. But after this video was posted today, I'm gonna try to get those two videos up, and if not, if I can't get those videos posted tomorrow, then I'm gonna film a story time or the Molly experience. But it just, like, takes so long for me to plan these fucking videos, because, like, I just took Molly again, and so my brain is just fucking fried, and I can't remember what I'm talking about for more than, like, a minute. And that's why, if you guys saw me look at my phone a bunch, I completely planned out this whole fucking video and, like, took pictures of it with this phone off that phone. I typed it in that phone and typed this whole thing out, what I was gonna talk about, because I literally can't remember, and I knew I'll forget a bunch of shit. And I know it's annoying as fuck when I cut in 24/7 and make long ass intros and shit. You're just gonna have to bear with me, because I'm a fucking stoner, and on top of that, I do other drugs, so my brain, it's just, slow. Slow. It's just a little slow. So let's hit this pen a little bit, and then I'm gonna talk about the next thing. Actually, I think I know what the next video is about to be on. I think it's going to be the start of a new series. I think I'm about to start some trouble for myself where I live. But I don't care. One other thing, I completely stopped smoking cigarettes. Well, not smoking, but buying. I'm not gonna buy any more cigarettes. Like, if I'm around someone and they offer me a cigarette, I'll smoke it. But for the most part, because I bought like 8 packs in 2 weeks, and that's a little disgusting. So I'm just gonna stick to my vape because it's 50%, so it gets me a head buzz. It satisfies the craving, and this one is strawberry watermelon. It's a Puff Bar Plus, and it has 800 hits. It's like $18. The lighting makes my teeth look yellow. It's just the shadow, guys. My teeth aren't yellow. The normal Puff Bars do not last long at all. And they're like $12 to $14. And they only have like 200 to 400 hits. And this is 800 and it's only a little bit more. But if you're gonna get a vape, I would say get a bottle of juice and a refillable pod. It saves so much money, but there's just no vape shops open. So I'm just having my friends get me disposed right now. The next topic is my fucking exes keep texting me. My toxic ass exes keep texting me. And I was gonna explain that in this, but I had the brilliant idea of making a series because I've dated some crazy fucking people and some horrible fucking people and some scary fucking people. So I'm gonna make a series on each and every single one of them. Only the interesting ones though, because most of them really fucked me up. So we're gonna make it a series. And because all of these people are gonna be in future story times, but me and Cheyenne are gonna come up with code words for absolutely everyone, because I'm not trying to get in trouble. So I think that's about it for this story. I mean, story, my fried ass. This update. I hope you guys open your mind to new experiences and enjoy your life to the fullest. Bye!
Me in the backseat, baby, make it last. I remember last week, came too fast. Little Pete nasty, scratches on the back. But I got racks, and she loving all my tats. Making money back. You wanna roll around town with me? Making money, roll around downtown with me. Everybody wanna roll around town with me? Making money, roll around downtown with me. I'll be in the backseat smoking on thrash.